Welcome to the Faith Formation session of St. Joseph Academy's Virtual Admission Information Series. I am Diana Fogarty, Director of Admission, along with Miss Alison Barberic, Theology Teacher and Department Chair of our Core Ministry Theology Department. Each of these sessions are designed to highlight the many wonderful opportunities that St. Joseph Academy has to offer its students and their families. But before we begin to talk about our faith formation, I would like to introduce Miss Barberic. Ms. Barberic, thank you for being with us.
You're welcome.
So Ms. Barberic is a graduate of SJA from the class of 2001. From there, she attended St. Vincent College in Pennsylvania, then earned her master's degree in theology from St. Mary's Seminary in Wycliffe. She's been a teacher and campus minister here since 2005 and has served as department chair of CORE of our CORE ministry department since 2015. Ms. Barberic, welcome again.
Thank you.
Tell me one of your favorite things you like about working at St. Joseph Academy?
Yeah, absolutely. I love the opportunity to journey with our students as they grow in faith. It's just such a privilege to be invited into our students' stories and to hear their struggles and their blessings. And really every day feels like a new chance for me to see God's grace at work in their lives.
I know. And honestly, I'm just talking with all of the theology teachers. You guys all share that same love for our kids.
Yes.
And they are. They are wonderful. And that's about all I can say is I love working here just as much. And I love working with all of the theology department. Ms. Barberic, can you share with me how students grow in their faith at St. Joseph Academy?
Sure. St. Joseph Academy provides so many opportunities for our students to grow in their faith and to recognize God in their lives and the importance of God in their lives, and then to understand the impact that they can have on the lives of our dear neighbors in Cleveland and beyond.
And can you explain a little bit on how that happens?
Sure. So through service and worship, retreats and catechesis, CORE ministry fosters the spiritual growth of the St. Joseph Academy community. And we prepare students for lifelong discipleship. So it's really a faceted approach, curriculum, retreats, and service all working together.
Wonderful. And I know theology is a course that the girls will take all 4 years at the academy. Can you tell me what theology courses are offered?
Sure. So as you said, it's a requirement for all students for one semester for each of their 4 years at St. Joseph Academy. So students will take them in sequential order in one semester, beginning with Theology 9 through Theology 12.
Gotcha. So what type of topics are covered each year?
So we always begin with the history and charism of our sponsors, the Sisters of the Congregation of St. Joseph. And then other topics include sacred scripture, the church in the world, and the social teaching of the church. And all of these topics will be discussed over and throughout the 4 years of our students here.
Wonderful. And I know as a senior, the 12th grade level class facing history is so different from all the other theology courses. Can you explain how that is different?
Yeah, it's such a great course. So facing history is unique because it's co-taught with a member of the social studies department. And it's an opportunity for our students to look at major social issues like poverty and racism and gender equality from both a social and a theological lens. So if we can try to understand how our faith informs the way that we work for the rights of other people, that becomes so important, especially for our seniors as they're about to leave our academy for the wider community.
Right, it is really important. Mm-hmm. And I know we do have retreats. Are they a requirement at St. Joseph Academy?
Yes, they are. So all of our students will participate in retreats, and we offer a wide variety. So our freshmen and sophomores will attend a day retreat, and then juniors can attend a day retreat or a 3-day Kairos retreat. And then we try to offer our seniors a real variety so that it can really suit their spiritual needs. Last year alone, we offered and planned 10 different retreats for our seniors, including an overnight cycling retreat on the towpath in the Cuyahoga Valley National Park, and even a silent retreat for a group of girls at the Jesuit Retreat Center.
I know our girls love the retreats. They really do. So do we hold Mass at St. Joseph Academy?
We do. We come together as a community at least once a month, and we offer students the opportunity to play various roles in the Mass. So our students are lectors, music ministers, Eucharistic ministers, and on holy days, and then just on other special occasions, we will attend Mass in the Academy Center. Obviously, due to COVID-19 guidelines, the way that we celebrate Mass will look very different, but we're still committed to coming together to pray as a community in some way.
Wonderful. And I know, I was just wondering if you could explain the character of the St. Joseph Academy graduate to our incoming families.
Sure. So 4 years of spiritual development enable our students to embody the qualities of what we call the character of a St. Joseph Academy graduate, which is a formalization of the philosophy that's really guided the Academy since its foundings. So in the tradition of our sponsors, the Congregation of St. Joseph, a graduate of St. Joseph Academy is a woman of unifying love through empathetic justice, service to the dear neighbor without distinction, personal integrity, and emerging wisdom.
Wonderful. And are there any designated spaces for our students to pray and reflect at the Academy?
Yes, and we have spaces in both the Academy building and in Fitzmaurice Hall. So in the Academy building, students can use the chapel. They can also go outside in our beautiful backyard. And then at Fitzmaurice, we have dedicated areas for prayer and reflection, including a really beautiful prayer space that's right next door to the classroom that I'm teaching in this year.
Wonderful. And so I know a lot of our girls do service. Is there a service requirement each year?
Yes. So students are required to perform a minimum of 20 hours of service each year. And over the past 4 years, our students have performed 103,630 hours of community service, and 82% of our students exceed their service hour requirement.
That's amazing, and that's an amazing number. Why do students go over their requirements?
I think it's often that students just fall in love with a particular organization. So, you know, once they have a chance to explore the different service opportunities when maybe they're freshmen and sophomores, they usually find something that really speaks to them. So we have students who dedicate hours of volunteering to Fairview Hospital, for example. Others work at Youth Challenge or the Arupe Homework Club. There are just so many opportunities, and it's really amazing to see what they end up doing.
So how would students learn about service opportunities?
So each week we provide a list of opportunities. We email them out to students and we post them in the school. But students are really encouraged to do what speaks to them. And so they don't have to choose from the opportunities that we provide them. And then students keep a log, which helps them keep track of their progress throughout the year.
Wonderful. So talk to me a little bit about service projects. What are some of the service projects that we offer?
Sure. So in addition to the ones I mentioned, students have done just so many unique things in this past year. Last year, we had 75 students volunteer to provide childcare for healthcare workers during the COVID-19 pandemic. Other students participated in a program called Opening Minds Through Art, which is an award-winning program that pairs them with residents in nursing homes who have dementia and Alzheimer's and helps them create artwork. We've also had students who modify power wheels for children with disabilities through the Go Baby Go program. So there are just so many cool things that our students are doing.
Wonderful. Can you tell me about our service immersion trips?
Yes. So students have the opportunity to serve the dear neighbor locally and globally. And so we offer week-long service immersion trips to places like West Virginia, where we have developed a great relationship with an organization there, Louisiana, Kentucky, Arizona, and the Dominican Republic. And they apply for these trips on an annual basis and are chosen and then work to prepare for the trip, which usually happens on spring break or in the summer. And service will serve certainly have to look a little bit different this year, but we know that it's important for our students to do service and to give back. And so we are working hard to find opportunities for them.
And I know it's important. A lot of girls are chosen to be that, but they do need to apply.
Yes.
So that's wonderful. So how did the core ministry department help keep students, faculty, and staff growing in their faith through the past spring with the COVID-19 pandemic?
It was really important for us to maintain our connections as a spiritual community. So we created an Instagram account specifically for daily prayer, as well as an email account for members of the community to send in prayer requests. And we just wanted to give everyone an opportunity to pray together. So we had a virtual mass for our seniors and their families, as well as a prayer service for the entire community, students, faculty, and staff.
I know. And, you know, and just speaking from the admissions point of view, I know the core ministry department reached out to us and they sent a note to every one of our class of 2024 recipients. And it just really touched me. That was just such a nice touch that we, you know, that we offered to the families.
Absolutely.
So Alison, thank you so much. Can you let me know where someone might be able to find all the information about our spiritual development and service?
Sure, all of this information is located on our Academy Life page under the Faith and Service tab of our website.
Wonderful. And Alison, thank you so much for your time. And please tune in for our next session as we highlight another area of St. Joseph Academy. And as always, feel free to reach out to one of us if you have any questions.